Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about dividing fractions today. When we divide improper or proper fractions, we start by finding the reciprocal of the divisor. Then we follow the rules for multiplication. Make sure you change mixed numbers into improper fractions before you begin. To find the reciprocal of a fraction, swap the numerator with the denominator. So we're just going to write these in the different way. So instead of having 4 over 5, we're going to write it as 5 over 4. That's the reciprocal. What would the reciprocal of 3 over 2 be? It'd be 2 over 3. What about 5? Well, we can always put a 1 under a whole number to make it a fraction, and then it's easier to see the reciprocal, which would be 1 over 5. And finally, 1 over 7, the reciprocal would be 7 over 1. Notice we don't always put a 1 under a number like that, but we would if we were specifically looking for the reciprocal. Okay, when you divide, you find the reciprocal, then you change the division to a multiplication sign. And what are we finding? We're finding the reciprocal of the divisor. And so which one is the divisor? Well, every time you have a fraction written in this format, the number that comes first is the dividend. And the number that comes secondly is the divisor. So the divisor is the second term. That's the one we find the reciprocal for. So we have 1 over 5, and this is going to become 10 over 7. That's the reciprocal. We're just flipping it. And then we're going to change the division into multiplication. Now, if we can cross-cancel, we will. 5 goes into itself one time, and it goes into 10 twice. If I multiply straight across, 1 times 2 is 2, and 1 times 7 is 7. There's my answer. For the second one, this one's a dividend. Don't flip it. This is the divisor. Do flip it. Once you flip, then you change your division symbol into multiplication. Multiplying straight across, I get 5 times 5 is 25, and 6 times 6 is 36. So if you ask me, why didn't you cancel that one? You did the last one. There's nothing to cancel. There has to be a common factor between the numerators and the denominators, which there wasn't. Okay, what about this one? I have 11 24ths as the dividend, not flipping that one. I have 22 over 35. That one I am going to find the reciprocal, which is 35 over 22. My division becomes multiplication. What do I have in common here? Well, I have 11 goes into itself once, and 22 goes into 22 twice, sorry. And then 24 and 35. Is there anything in common between those two numbers? I don't think so. So I'm just going to multiply across. 1 times 35 is 35, and 24 times 2 is 48. What if you got an answer and you weren't sure if it could be reduced or not? You could use your calculator. Whichever calculator you have, you can go onto YouTube and ask somebody on YouTube how to do this. They'll have a video up there. If you have this anything with a fraction button, that's going to look something like this. We're going to have 35, hit that fraction button to make it a fraction, and then over 48. And then I can hit enter and see how that's still 35 48. That means it can't be reduced. There was no other common factor in there. If I had put in there, let's say 70 over 48, oops, I don't want to do that. I want to do 70 fraction over 48. If you put it in as a division, it's going to give you a decimal answer. But as a fraction, it knows what you want it to do, and then it says, oh, that's 35 over 24. You see how it reduces when it can? But this one couldn't be, so we're fine. Okay, then we have these problems, and these problems I just wanted to talk about because you cannot have zero as a divisor. If you do, you get undefined. If you put that into your calculator, because you're not sure which one of these is bad and one of these not, well, if you put it into your calculator, 1/2 divided by 0, your calculator is going to tell you that's an error. You can't divide by 0. That's undefined. But if you put it in the other way, 0 divided by 1/2, that's 0. So it's okay if it comes first, it's going to be 0. If it comes secondly, it's undefined. You can use your calculator to help you figure that out. Like I said before, we have to change these fractions into improper before we can work with them. 3 times 5 is 15, plus 3 is 18. And then I'm not changing that division symbol yet because I'm still working on getting them into the proper form. 2 times 10 is 20, plus 1 is 21. Now I'm going to do this. Keep the dividend the same. Find the reciprocal for the divisor and multiply. 5 goes into itself once and into 10 twice. 3 goes into 18 6 times and into 21 7 times. And if I multiply straight across, 6 times 2 is 12 and 1 times 7 is 7. That's a perfectly acceptable answer, and if your instructor is asking you to change it into a mixed number, you can. Remember how to do that. 7 goes into 12 one time with 5 left over. So that would be 1 and 5 sevenths if you were asked to put that into a mixed number form. Here what I would do is I would make 7 into 7 over 1. So it's a fraction, it's an improper fraction. And then I would still leave the division symbol. 2 times 3 is 6, plus 2 is 8. And now I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal of the divisor. Notice there's nothing to cross-cancel here. 3 times 7 is 21. 1 times 8 is 8. That's going to be my final answer. Again, I could change that into a mixed number if I wanted to. 8 goes into 21 twice. 2 times 8 is 16. That means there's 5 left over again. 8 times 2 is 16 plus 5 is where that 21 came from. Last problem, it could ask you to find the quotient of something. A quotient means to divide, and when you say quotient, whatever you say first has to come first. So it has to be this way, 6/7 divided by 1 4/5. We don't always put the greatest number first. We have to put it in the order that they were stated. 6/7 doesn't change, and right now 1 times 5 is 5 plus 4 is 9/5. Now I can divide that. I'm going to take the dividend and leave it the same. That is 6/7 times 5 over 9. I can simplify here because 3 goes into 6 twice and into 9 3 times. And 2 times 5 would be 10, and 7 times 3 would be 21. Now remember, you can do this on your calculator, and for me, I'm totally fine with you doing that. If you're in class, you can ask questions on how to do that, or ask the internet by going to YouTube and typing in what you want to know. Have a fantastic day.